My name is Yasin Siddharth, aka Stunt Boss, Rada ZX6R, 09 model, Kawasaki. So this started about 8 years back, just riding with cousins and just enjoying myself on the streets of Trinidad, and we wanted to take it up a notch then. You know, we always pushing the limits, and you know, stunt riding was like the ultimate thing you could do on a motorcycle. Approximately about 8 years now, been riding about 8 years now, on and off, but training for stunt riding seriously about five years now. Some of the specs on the bikes are like, you know, we upgrade the throttle, we put on a cage, we upgrade the caliper system on the bike, we have a easy pull clutch, understand? Basically that is it, you know. And one major thing we did is we upgrade the frame of the bike to take the falls and stuff, because with stunt riding you get a lot of falls. It wasn't really hard, you know, it was more like a passion, because I mean it's something you love doing, so you know, you put your heart into it like anything else. To wheel it, basically. And to do shows, I mean, to entertain kids, that is what we really like to do, you know. I like to be a positive role model for people out there. It's giving you a feeling of accomplishment, you're trying to reach a goal and you're achieving it, you know, and certain times you're trying new tricks and you get it, so you pass a kind of mental barrier. It's a real frightening thing to, you know, attempt as well, but you know, when you get the accomplishment of doing a new trick, it's like a adrenaline rush then, you know. Well, in the past you used to get like real nervous and stuff like that, but it's a little too prayer, and then you're just keeping your confidence where you practice over, you know, the many years we riding, you know, internationally and locally. Well, Mad Max, of course, you know, that's my boy, you know, from ever since, so you know, we always training together, we always practicing together, so that's the person I'm most comfortable with riding with, you know. So, well, I used to be into cars, I had a RX-7 third generation, right, but the kind of money I spend behind a road trip, the cheapest speed you could get other than a car is a bike, you understand? And it's, you know, it just like progress after that into stunting later on, you know. So basically just to get more exposure of the sport, you know, more interviews like this, you know, get the word out there that look, it have this taking place in Trinidad as well, you know. So it's basically the same thing, getting the exposure and, you know, getting your name out there, so when you get that popularity, the sponsor will take notice, you know, and they would want to build that support base as well for you, you know. No, I wouldn't say so, because it's a passion, it's something you love doing, I mean, and you enjoy it, so I will look at it as a waste of money. Yeah, of course, man, I could compete internationally, just the opportunities when it presents itself, if you're available to do it at the time, you know. Not really had no plans, really, just enjoy riding and having fun with friends. Right, so I just want to say, you know, thanks for all the support over the years, and I really appreciate you guys, and I really try to be a positive role model for everyone. I mean, not everybody perfect, we all have we faults as well, you know, me included. But you know, we really should try our best to be positive for the youths and them, so at least when they look at us, they have examples to follow, you know. And that is why I try to portray all the time with a lot of charity shows I do for free. You know, I try to send a positive message basically every time, even using motorbike, you know, and using stunt riding. I always try a little religious talk into it, you know, always try to uplift people then basically with it. And over the years, seeing that people really appreciate that, you know, and given the opportunities at Baraka Ground and other places, and you know, we do a lot of shows like in the underprivileged areas and stuff like that, and just seeing like the youths and them smiles and the, you know, the likes and the, you know, the basically the love we get out here now, you know, is really encouraging. And I hope you guys continue to, you know, show all your support in that sense, you know. Basically the shows what we do for like charity events, I'll say that, because you know, like all the young kids and they come around the bike and everybody wanna sit on the bike, and you know, the love behind it now. You know, it's really nice to do like these type of events and get the youths involved now. You know, all in all, Trinidad going these days, you know. And the more we could get youths off of the streets and get them into something positive, advertising message we try to push, you know, and seeing how they react with motorbikes, you know, and using this as a tool to kind of guide them through now. You understand? Because, I mean, not everybody go on to play football and cricket. You know, it have other means for them, it have other sports available towards them, you know. Right, so basically I want to shout out my cousin, Ben Stanton. You know, he really support me over the years, and I'm thankful for that. Also family as well for being patient with me. Plenty times we go and do shows on a Sunday, and we do practices on Sundays and stuff like that. So, you know, it's a lot of support from your family as well. You know, wife and kids as well, you know. So, yeah, that is about it. And Mad Max and FC Media for the interview. You know, big up Chubbs.